So, Apostasy. This is a feature debut from writer-director Daniel Cocotallo, and it's a very confident one at that. Centering around a single mother and her two daughters who are members of the Jehovah's Witnesses community, the film picked up a minor prize at this year's London Film Festival, and I must say I think it's very well deserved. The performances from the three leads are outstanding, and all feel incredibly natural. Siobhan Fernahan manages to play the family's matriarch with such sensitivity and understanding that you manage to connect with her despite some of her actions, while both Sasha Parkinson and Molly Wright are revelations. Both of their performances feel so real that they transcend acting to the extent that you feel like you're watching a real person. And because of this, the film can get quite depressing at times as you see just how this cult impacts and consumes their lives. During the first act of the film, I was thinking it would be nice if we could get some scenes where the characters are not doing or talking about anything religious. But then you slowly realize that those scenes aren't in the movie because they just don't happen in these characters' lives. This brings me onto the script, which I feel has a lot of very interesting subtleties to it. In addition to the dialogue feeling very real, the precise wording of some of the lines shows an almost discreet self-awareness amongst some of the characters, that they know that what they're doing is indoctrinating and taking advantage of certain characters' mental states, and it's shown in a very realistic and understated manner. If there's one problem with the film, then it would definitely be the cinematography. Now, I do love my Academy ratio and largely shallow depths of field cinematography, but in this film, the cinematography felt rather bare bones. With the notable exceptions of a few shots, it felt like they were trying to shoot the film in the most efficient way, rather than in any sort of interesting way. And though this does add to the film's very social realist aesthetic, I think the film would have benefited from a more thorough visual style. Anyway, despite that, I still really enjoyed this film, and I genuinely hope some of the performances garner awards in the future. And I'm gonna give it a 7 out of 10.